So I'm here today to talk to you about the power of the t-shirt, and of course, first problem, I'm not having the content to wear. So before I talk about t-shirts, I want to talk about America's obsession with memes. Keep calm, carry on. That's not even American yet. We see it everywhere. Tebow, I mean, the guy's just staying true to himself. You are not the father. You don't love that one, right? Who here hasn't been Rickrolled? So, you know, people think of memes as an internet phenomenon, but really, they've been around for years. A guy by the name of Richard Dawkins. No, that's Richard Dawson. Richard Dawkins, this guy, actually, was a scientist who coined the phrase and has said that they've been around for years and years and years. And what does this mean? To me, my position is that the t-shirt has been the most influential medium of memes for the last century. So before I sell you on this, I gotta tell you a little bit of history. So in 1913, the US Navy makes it mandatory regulation that sailors wear t-shirts. In the 20s, USC, they all wore them under their uniforms to prevent chafing. In 1951, Marlon Brando, and then in the 60s, the tie-dye made it catch on like fire. In the 70s, we had heat application, which made it explode. I just used that because Kirk Cameron, really? I mean, that's bad. In the 80s, we kind of tried to get away from that. I started my personal Pearl Jam collection that I still have today, and then in today's age, Angry Birds. Very interesting. 1948, Thomas Dewey runs against Harry Truman. This is the first printed t-shirt. It's actually at the Smithsonian. This was his button he was handing out, though. Okay for buttons, but a little too risque for t-shirts at the time, the first printed shirt. Anybody tell me what that is?
Mickey Mouse!
How do you know that? From being there? No, that image was branded via a t-shirt. The power of the t-shirt, behold. Okay, anybody speak Thai? How about Chinese or Hebrew? No? Can you tell me what that is? A t-shirt did that, and remember that. And we're waiting. Okay, very big moment, 1977. This guy's name is Milton Glaser. And the city of New York was considered to be a dump, crime-ridden, not a good place to be. The Commerce Commission actually hired this guy to come up with something, and he came up with I Love New York. Think about what that image meant to you, you know, in 2000, and think about what it meant on September the 12th, 2001, right? It took on a completely different meaning. By the way, that is the most replicated t-shirt in the world. So why do I care so much about t-shirts? Well, because they transcend emotion. You can see how emotional I am. They're great for events. you know, my wife asks them. But they express where we're going, and they tell stories of where we've been. You know, who we're for, and my wife's shirt, who she's with. I mean, t-shirts are what transcend emotion. So they also help us identify with a group. I could not find a picture of a family reunion in Overton's Park. I don't understand. They happen all the time. This just warms the cockles of my heart. But they also help us stand out as an individual. I mean, who doesn't want to be Lenny Kravitz, but maybe in a completely different way? Right? They show off where we work. Or sometimes how hard we do. Right? They're a business card and they're a billboard. Insert dramatic pause here. They tell us, you know, who we once were, or tried to forget, or who we're soon to be. By the way, that's a baby on a board, if you didn't catch that. Baby on a board. Very cool. You know, who we wish we were back then, or were we kidding, probably still a little bit today. Right? Now, anybody ever had this as a spring clean? And, honey, can I throw this out? No, but you never wear it. Yeah, look it. So then I can throw it out? Are you stupid? Right? They really tell our story. What we eat, what we drink, what we smoke, what we ride, what we're an advocate for, and we're against. T-shirts transcend. Insert pause. Okay, so again, a meme is an idea, a behavior, or a style that spreads from person to person. Remember that time that you were so, so, so clever on MySpace? Oh, you're right, neither do we. I mean, it's gone. In this world of the internet today, like, it's in a moment and it's gone. But imagine, my friends, imagine that idea on a t-shirt. Anybody have a t-shirt in the room? Show of hands. Older than your wife? Older than your marriage, your house, your car? No, just me? Well, this is where I go over on you. Everyone pretending tonight, it's an I Survived, Ignite Memphis, and all I got was this lousy t-shirt. So make some noise for that!